What's up, guys? Of course, I'm back with another video for you. This time is the Beginner's Guide to the Gym, Part 2. This video is going to be about motivation and nutrition side. The nutrition I won't go into full detail about, but I am going to give you a roundabout idea of my tips and everything I have on it. So let's get into the video. I think is very important. If you have already started, say that you started a New Year's resolution and you are getting in the gym, and you know you wanted to lose weight or build muscle or whatever gym fitness goal you were trying to go for, you know, you might start lose motivation by now. You may be really tired of going, you may even feel already burnt out on going, or you've just had struggles with your nutrition and you think that eating healthy and counting calories, counting macros, whatever you're doing is hard and you can't do it, but I'm here to tell you that you can. Time to get used to doing it, and it takes patience, it takes dedication, but it's not hard. February this month, I am entering into my 11th month that I have started my fitness journey. So in those 10 months, I have just learned so much about myself and tips and things that I've found that works for myself. That's why I started this channel, is because I want to help you guys, you know, get to the place where I am. What I want to bring to everyone's attention is that eating healthier, doing a little bit of exercise, really gets you to that better self, acceptance, appreciation. You're proud of yourself, you look better, you feel better, you have more energy, and you're prolonging your life. So you're sitting here and, you know, you're finding yourself with, you know, man, I don't want to diet anymore, it sucks, you know, I feel hungry, I'm tired, I'm really not finding time to get to the gym as much as I would like, and or I've not seen results. Any of these things that you're probably facing right now, or you may not be facing them now, but you will eventually. I'm just gonna give you a little insight of how to overcome those and really stick to your goals and really reach them. I don't work. I'm blessed that I don't have to work. I don't have any children, so yes, my life is really easy to fit everything in, but I have worked before. And so I know what it's like, you know, to get off work and be tired and to come home. However, I do not have kids, so I can't say that I know what it's like to have a kid or kids. It comes to a point. How bad do you want it? They always say that you make time for your priorities. So if you have your priorities, or you have your goals in your top priorities, you will make time for it. Again, there's many other things like family, friends, kids, whatever, that comes first before, you know, fitness goals. Since you aren't used to doing it, you just, that's just it. You're not used to doing it. You're not used to making the time. You're not used to watching what you eat. You know, you're used to convenience. It's really hard to change yourself, you know, in ways of thinking that yes, you do have time, you can make time, and you can eat healthy when you go out and you want to ride a bicycle or you want to learn how to ride a bicycle, you're going to learn how to ride a bicycle because that's what you want. This is the same tactic that you need to put into your fitness goals, weight loss goals, whatever kind of goals you have that will help you, that will help you push. I mean, you really have to want it. That's bottom key, you have to want it. So after that, that's when the motivation comes in. You know, you have your goal, like I said in my last video. If you haven't seen my last video, I will link it down below, the part one, so you can go and watch that. Do go and check that out before you watch this video, because this one just kind of adds more to it. But once you have that goal, you know, you set that goal, you figured out what you want to do, that's when your motivation kicks in. You want something, you want it, and depending on how bad you want it depends on how quickly you're gonna get it, how much motivation you're gonna keep during the process of you getting towards that goal. But with that said, everyone, including me, even though I love working out, there is days that I wake up that I'm tired, I'm sore, you know, maybe I just don't feel like going to the gym. I just ask myself, am I being really lazy? Or do I really need a break? Do I see myself getting burnt out? Do I need to take a couple of days? Don't take a week. A week is just an excuse to quit. You know, there's days that I wake up that I'm like, man, I don't want to go into the gym and, you know, work out, sweat. I want to sleep in. Or maybe there's days that you come home and you've had a hard day at work and, you know, you just want to sit on the couch and relax. And, you know, you have to ask yourself, do you really need that day off? Which there is days that, yes, you need to, you know, your mind sometimes isn't in the right state of mind. So yes, there's days that you need to take off. Just, you know, relax. If you feel like you're starting to get burnt out, take a couple of days off. If you're training 3 days a week, you know, miss one day. You don't have to push yourself, but you still have to try. You can't stop trying, because if you stop trying, then that's when you first give up on your goal. So yes, we have those days that we don't feel like it, but if we ask ourselves, do we really need to take those days off? Or if it's just a lazy excuse that we're trying to make for ourselves. If it is a lazy excuse, this is really hard. But you have to give yourself tough love. And in that time, it's really hard to talk yourself into getting motivated when you're already unmotivated. But this is what I do. On the back screen of my phone, I have it on my lock screen and my home screen of my iPhone. I have either pictures of myself where I videoed a workout, you know, showing my muscles, or maybe I found a good quote, and I will save it to my one of the lock screens so I can see it every time I'm on my phone. Because of course, we know all millennials and even older people, everyone's on their phone these days. So it's something that you're always seeing. If you have to, put post-it notes on your bathroom mirror, on your kitchen, or somewhere in your kitchen. Put post-it notes at your work, around your work, if you are allowed, which I'm sure you are, to put a little post-it note somewhere. Put it in your car. Put things where you visually see something, like a quote that maybe you've liked, or a picture of yourself, that when you see it, it makes you think of your goal. And when you start thinking about your goal, then you start thinking and asking yourself, is it worth it? Do I really want it? And if you do really want it, then you'll find a way to motivate yourself to get up and not skip that day at the gym. Before this past year, I tried to have my fitness journey many, many times. I tried yo-yo diets. I tried everything, and I quit, so I know what it's like to quit, and I know the thoughts that you think when you talk yourself out of your goal. So I know what it's like. I know, you know, even nowadays that, you know, I'm closer, I've met many of my goals, I still get unmotivated, and I just have to ask myself, you know, really sit down and ask myself, how bad do I want it? What can I do to get myself motivated? Do I need to get on Pinterest, the internet, YouTube? Do I need to watch videos? Do I need to get on Pinterest or just on Google and look up, you know, inspiring quotes, fitness quotes? Anything that sparks your inspiration will get you motivated again. So really the key to being motivated is to always keep something in front of your face that reminds you of your goals. You have to keep your goals in mind. I'm not saying that you're gonna have 100% motivation throughout this entire process, because you're not. I had to search for my motivation, and that's what you have to do. When you're unmotivated, you have to search for it. You have to find it. And that fire comes from, how bad do you want your goal? Alright, the next thing that I'm going to talk about is nutrition. And even though I do like the fitness side and I love working out, the nutrition side is what I've probably learned the most about and what I had room to learn the most about. I already kind of knew, you know, the gym equipment and how to use that and everything on that side. But the nutrition is where I lacked. I didn't know much. I didn't know what worked, what I was supposed to be doing according to the goals that I had. So we'll get into this second part of the video. All right, the number one thing that I have to say first and foremost when nutrition subject comes up is you can't out-exercise a bad diet. I'm sure you've heard that before now. It's very common and it's very true. I'm sure you've seen like the percentages, like 80% nutrition and 20% gym, or sometimes I've seen it 70 and 30. Those are true. Nutrition is majority of your gonna be the results of your goal. All right, so now let's get into what I hear almost all the time on social media, or what I read all the time on social media. People say eating healthy is really hard. When I started my fitness journey 10 months ago, I wouldn't consider that it was hard. It was just different. I wasn't used to eating healthy. I wasn't used to focusing on what I actually put in my mouth. Eating healthy is not hard at all. Again, if you're wanting to start eating healthy, it goes just like I said with the motivation. Depends on how bad you want that goal. If your goals are weight loss or strength, you know, if you're really focusing on cutting your calories or carb cycling or anything like that for weight loss, you know, you're going to want to put 110% in it if you really want to lose weight. The excuses usually are thrown out the door depending on how much you want that goal. I'm not saying that healthy eating is easy, because it's not at first. And I can tell you from my own experience. When I first started this, like I told you, nutrition was not my strong suit. I didn't know a lot about it. Of course, you know, I was like, oh, I need to eat chicken, I need to eat fish, I need to eat vegetables. You know, I don't need to eat a lot of carbs. But within that, I didn't know how to track carbs. I didn't know how to track macros. I didn't know my portions, how different they should be, and how it would affect me. What I did was I got on the internet and found reliable sources, which some of them I wish I would have saved so I could share with you guys, but I didn't. I know my number one that I still go to today is bodybuilding.com, because they have tons of articles and videos that you can watch. So I know that's one of them that I went to try to learn and figure out. I also rented books from the library, got on YouTube, and you know, I did research on there, and that's where I actually learned about nutrition. And I've learned this entire past 10 months, you know, I learned something every day. I'm still learning. I still get books to learn more. I mean, the level is not capped. at all. You can always be learning. The same with nutrition, fitness, anything. Back to just tracking my calories on my phone app, which there's two apps that I've used in my journey, but the one I like over the other one is my Myfitnesspal app. The other one I used to use was called Mynetdiary. I do like it, but Myfitnesspal, I pay the subscription so I can do my extra like macros and all the actual like technical stuff. Going from regular eating, like, you know, your normal, you know, you just eat whatever you want, going to that and have to track it and have to really watch what you eat is it's difficult at first because it's a change. You never want to drastically change anything in the beginning. You always want to go for really small changes. Really small changes just add up to a really big change in your progress. Okay, so my tip for you about cutting calories is to never cut a whole bunch of calories. You know, it can damage your body in really bad ways, like lifetime, like damage your body. I mean, you can really hurt yourself if you really don't know what you're doing and you're cutting a lot of calories. If you're just starting, you never should cut a whole bunch of calories. It's not gonna help you get to your goal faster. It's actually, sometimes it can make you retain weight and retain water because your body all of a sudden starts holding on to these nutrients and extra fats and stores them as fat, so it can use it for fuel later because you're basically starving yourself. You can be lenient and still eat healthy. Like, I have a cheat meal once a week. I do that to keep my insanity. I do that to rev up my metabolism, to kind of restart it, kickstart it. For example, if you were on a low calorie diet and you were just strictly watching your calories, getting all three or all four, I guess, of your key ingredients, protein, protein, your fats, your carbs, and your veggies, if you're getting all that in your daily intake, if you're just watching your calories, then having a cheat meal is okay because your body is, you know, in a deficit, and it's, like I said, it's kind of restricting itself and not getting, you know, a bunch of nutrients that it expects and or it has expected in the past. So it starts adjusting and getting used to how you're eating and how much you're eating. So when you throw in a cheat meal and you completely give your body something that it's not used to, you know, it revs your metabolism up, which your metabolism can slow down if you're in a long calorie deficit for a really long time. Yeah, so if you throw in that cheat meal, like pizza or something, I don't mean eat the whole thing. I usually get a thin cheese pizza and eat 2 to 3 slices. So by eating that, you get your body restarted and it gets those extra nutrients and it gets excited and happy. And then once you go back to your low calorie diet, then you just start all over again, and you know, it slowly slows down, your metabolism slowly slows down again, and you just do it every week, just, you know, just a refeed. Yes, nutrition is not hard. You don't have to starve yourself to eat healthy. You are allowed to have chicken, shrimp, fish, lean meat, lean red meat. You're allowed to have carbs. You can have carbs. It's better or best to have complex carbs like brown rice, oatmeal or oats, beans, anything like that, lentils. Those are your good complex carbs that you can have. So just be sure to adjust your calories to your liking and don't subtract too much from your actual like maintain goal. I will link a link down below that will take you to a website where you can enter in your weight, your height, all that, and you can get your maintained calorie goal, and you're able to go from there. So I will link that down below so you're able to click on it, enter in your stuff, and figure out that if you don't have an app or if you don't want to use an app. The key to nutrition really is just focusing on what really goes in your mouth. Small changes like watching, you know, your carb proportion. What I do is I eat my protein first. I eat my veggies second because I don't like veggies, okay? Sometimes if it's something like broccoli, I really don't like broccoli, I will make myself eat my broccoli proportion first on my plate, and then I will go to my protein. I always eat my carbs last because sometimes I don't eat my whole plate because I'm full. When you feel full, you're full. Don't eat no more. Another suggestion that I will give you is if you find yourself feeling hungry, then eat. If you feel hungry, then you need to eat. But with that being said, there's a difference from feeling hungry and sitting on the couch watching TV and being bored and just want something in your mouth. This is where your mind kind of plays games with you. And that's where you have to really take over your mind and tell it, you know, no, I'm in control. I'm not hungry. One thing that will keep you from not feeling hungry throughout the day when you really aren't is in taking a lot of water. It helps, you know, flush the bad toxins out. It helps keep us deep bloated. Also, another thing, if I am truly hungry and I need a snack, I always go for something like peanut butter or something that has protein in it, so it makes you feel fuller longer. And that's able to, you know, just make you go until your next meal. So I'm not like truly like really, really hungry and I'm just craving something sweet. I'll either get like a tablespoon of peanut butter and just eat it off the spoon, or I will, you know, get like a couple of pretzels out and chew on those. Yogurt is a really good thing. If you're craving something sweet, you can have some yogurt with maybe some fruit in it or some granola stuff in it. It's just little key things that you can change here and there that you'll realize later on that, wow, this isn't, you know, I'm not always hungry and I am able to eat when I am hungry, and that you don't have to deprive yourself of food. Nutrition is key into a fitness lifestyle. It's not hard. It's different at first, and it seems hard at first, but it's not hard. It's just a change. You're not used to it. Here's the thing you have to remember. You can't cut too many calories because your body still needs nutrients. If you cut too many calories, then you're just going to be hurting yourself, and you're going to be spinning your wheels, and you're more than likely going to be starving, and you're going to give up, and it's basically just going to be like a yo-yo diet. Like, you might have lost a little weight, but you're just going to gain it back because you quit. You have to really do your research. Like I said, I didn't know when I first started this, and I knew I didn't know, and I knew that I wanted to do it, so I knew I had to do the research. If you really liked this video, and again, if you hadn't seen the one before this, we'll link it down below so you can watch that, because it has great tips. It's like 6 or 7 tips to get you ready for the gym, how to plan your goals, what you need to do with your goals, you know, just key tips to having really success in the gym. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you are not subscribed to my channel, press that red button below. You will not regret it, and I will see you guys in my next video.